this RAM, and we'll see the what is the basic structure of RAM. So memory and processor, the designs are different. Memory and processor. So processor is a mostly a digital design, mostly digital. But this is hybrid, both analog and digital. Though there are no analog signals, but there are a lot of issues regarding the speed generalization, because memory is always faster. Memory is faster than the processor, always remember. So therefore, when you want to manufacture memory as an independent company, there are lots of many companies who make memories. For example, Intel has memories, but there are specific specialized Toshiba. Toshiba makes lots of memories. So these are memory companies. So this is the basic architecture of a read-only memory. This is rather, you can call it OTP, one-time programmable memory. You can call it as one-time programmable memory. OTP. One-time programmable memory, one-time. Can you see my writing?
Yes, sir.
So here it is basically set of switches, set of connections. So if there is a decoder, there is a 3-bit address which will select one of the lines. So 1 out of 8, you can say. So this is choose from 8. So the depending upon this A0, A1, A2 and enable, it will choose one line, means it will make it high voltage. Then by the way of these buffers, these are buffers, you can see the connection or no connection. So if it is connected, then it is connected to high voltage. If it is not connected, then it is grounded. So one of them become high, others are zero. So in that location, whatever is the content, it can be read here. So this is a simple OTP RAM. So this is done during manufacture. And this is the cheapest. And it is fastest also. The moment you give the address, you get the value. So it is the fastest variety of RAM, you can say. Fastest. It is basically a set of connections. The fastest RAM available. So how do you fabricate this RAM? This is basically connection and disconnections. You can do by way of addressing. There will be few bits of the addressing. So total number of addressing will be 2^n number of bits. If n is the number of addressing bits, 2^n number of locations are possible. Okay. So if you look at this, you know, in this, you can see. So this is the words which are stored in 8 locations. So depending upon a selection of these ABC values, you can select any one of them. You select any one of them, basically, depending upon these address values. Okay. So these are all masked program, because once you store it, it will not be changed. So this is basically the highest permeance possible. These are the highest permeance. This is OTP or max program RAM, one time programmable RAM, OTP, right? So this is what. It cannot be written. Once you store it, for example, you make anything, any device, product, like you are making a product, let's say, make a product. So in the product list, if you have a microcontroller with a flash, this is microcontroller, it has a flash memory. So you basically do OTP. Once your product is ready, you program the microcontroller right from the manufacturing. Or you So this will be a very low cost flash, because flash is expensive. Flash memory is expensive. That means read write fast is expensive. So if you go for OTP, the cost will reduce. Memory is more expensive than processor. I have a Mac here. So in the Mac, if I buy 1 GB of RAM, it will be 15,000 rupees. So if I add more RAM, you know, the cost will exponentially go high. 3 lakhs, you know, I have to pay extra 3 lakhs to increase the RAM to 64 gigabytes. I got 32 gigabytes. I had to add another 32 gigabytes. So it is very expensive. Therefore, memory can make the system low cost. So this EEPROM, erasable programmable read only memory, this can be programmed, but by you can erase them by use of ultraviolet rays. You can use ultraviolet rays, UV rays to erase it. So UV rays, you erase this, put it on a UV light. So these connections which you saw, these connections can be destroyed. You can create the connections by high voltage, applying high voltage. So this is called EEPROM. This is now almost outdated. It is nobody using it. So nowadays people are using EEPROM. So let us look at this EEPROM, how one of the chips which is very, so this is EEPROM. EEPROM means you can erase it. So this will be erased by electrical voltages. That means you can erase this instead of ultraviolet rays, you can erase it by applying higher voltage. Then you can program it applying little higher voltage. This is called EEPROM. So this is, if you make it faster, so this faster version of EEPROM is known as flash memory. This is the extension of EEPROM, as you can see here. Extension of EEPROM. This flash memory. This is extension. That means it is made faster. So homework, Pooja, please create a homework for these guys. Homework is find out the chips. Market and discuss about one of them. You cut and paste and give some ideas. Just on this is homework for today. Today is 1st February. Pooja, please create this homework. Let them upload whatever they know about flash memory. You create, find out a chip which is available in the market, then write about it in a word and upload it. You may cut and paste things, but I want you to learn. So based on this homework, you will have to appear the test. Homeworks and assignments. So then RAM is just a word, but everything which I discussed is random access. The access time is same, but we call it RAM because this is, you can read write. You can call it as read write memory, not RAM, but you can call it as read write memory. Okay. Instead of RAM, you can write as read write memory. This is read write. Instead of RAM, you call it read write memory. That means you can read and write at same speed. So therefore, it can be used as a scratch pad or the primary memory. It is mostly used for primary memory. That means read access and write access, they are same. All right. Sorry about it. Okay. So for example, I shall give a chip number which acts like a RAM. HM6264, let's say. HM6264. It's a high speed CMOS static RAM. HM 6264. You can download this PDF to all of you who want to learn. HM6264. You download all of you this PDF from your internet. HM6264A. HM6264A. Download this document because we will read this document. So the RAM, basically random access memory, there are two varieties. One is the static RAM. It is made up of flip-flops. And there is a dynamic RAM, primarily capacitors, which are refreshed again and again. The other two different types of RAM. So static RAM flip-flops means one flip-flop will take a lot of space. But DRAM will not take that much space. Okay. So let's talk about this little bit. Arif Javed, so what is your idea on the RAM?
Read-write memory.
Yes. So how it is different from EEPROM flash memory?
Sir, it is faster than EEPROM.
Why?
Sir, EEPROM generally uses ultraviolet to delete data.
Ultraviolet it can also erase by higher voltage.
Higher voltage.
Yes.
EEPROM.
So why you think that it is faster than this EEPROM? Okay, so you can mute yourself. Selubania Chandra Satish.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me what is the difference between this DRAM and SRAM? What is that RAM? DRAM, SRAM? I just said you are not paying attention to the class. I'm sorry about it. Selubania. Selubania, Chandra Satish.
Sorry, sir.
So please make a star mark, Puja. If he repeats this in future, then I will reduce one grade. Okay, Adarsh Soni, can you tell me what is the difference between this SRAM and DRAM? Adarsh Soni.
Hello, sir. Am I audible?
Yeah, you are audible.
Sir, SRAM uses a transistors to store the data.
Yes. So what is the full form of
static RAM and dynamic RAM?
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you for being attentive. Others can you go star mark do because you attentive hai. Akshay Sai Reddy Kondu.
Yes, sir.
So DRAM, I just said, made up of what?
Capacitors. CMOS and capacitor.
What about SRAM?
Sir, SRAM only consists of transistors.
That is true. Both are transistors. But SRAM, the basic building block is what? 1 bit of SRAM is basically what?
Flip-flop.
Not all. Okay, thank you very much for being attentive. Tinmay Chakrabarty. Can you tell me what is OTP RAM?
Sir, one time programmable RAM.
Why it is good to have OTP RAM? What is the advantage?
It cannot be erased at all.
That is true, but why people go for OTP RAM? What is the main advantage?
It is cheaper.
Thank you very much. Excellent, very nice. So you are very attentive. So I think so. You guys have to be attentive. Otherwise, I cannot take your class. If you are not interested to join, no problem. You do not have to come to the class. If you satisfy the assignments, coding, etc., you don't have to join the class. Okay. I'm not going to take your attendance. My attendance seriously. I will take your attendance, but I will not take it seriously because unnecessarily joining and then creating disturbance is not a good idea because I am getting reports from teachers that some of you are trying to lock them out, muting them. That's fine. Actually, you enjoy this, but don't do the class because it disturbs others who are serious learners. I am sure there are many serious learners in this class. They take this course very seriously. Most of you are coming with product ideas. I am very much impressed with that. I am giving full time. Remember this embedded system course is not, there is nothing, no book. It needs to be practiced. And this is what is the whole world now. Any product you see, any fancy product, starting from Google Home to all your cell phones, everything, entertainment products, computers, laptops, tabs, you know, are all embedded systems. And it happens in industry. So we are in the academics, we have to try to catch up with what these people are doing. So coming back to the course, so you can still see my screen, right? So all of you please download this HM6264A. This is a typical CMOS random access memory. It's a old memory, but look at the specifications. I am going to get back to you on the specifications. So what could be the specification of a RAM? The prime thing is how many address lines, right? For example, HM6264 has got 8192 WAD. WAD means 8-bit. 8-bit is its bit size. Okay. So you can see that. You can just download that in your computer. So HM6264A. Sorry.
Sir, it is Hitachi Semiconductor's data sheet, right?
Yes, it should be. You write HM6264A. Just write PDF, you download. Actually, this is old, so I think the IP is also open. It is like that. You know, anybody can make it. So H starts for Hitachi, it will be from Hitachi, but it is such a old chip. Even the IP is old for a particular company. You know, when you file an IP, every year you have to renew. IP means patent. Intellectual property, patent or copyright. When you write a software, it is a copyright. If you make a hardware, it is a patent in India. But in USA, it can be also idea, whatever. You can make patent. Once you do a patent, you have to renew every year, remember. Every year or 2 years. So after some time, you stop renewing, then the patent becomes open. Anybody can do it. Certain RAMs and certain processor architectures are like that. Anybody can download if they are not renewing that patent. So huge money is spent to file the IP. So the products which you are working on, I'll help you to write patents. You know, that will be part of your game. So you file those patents through your IIT so that you own this patent. So those who do a software, like file a copyright. Those who build a product or prototype, will file a patent. I'll help you to do that. So similarly, this kind of RAM, so you download, you can see, the primary focus on the specification is the number of address lines. So here how many? 8192 number of words it is saying. Eight one nine two means how many address lines? 2 to the power 10 is 2 to the power 10, 11, 12, 13. Right? 2 to the power 10 is 1024. So again you add 1, again you add, so 13 bits. So 13 address lines will be there. You check it. So then the bit size is 8-bit. That means each location is 8 bits. So this, whatever you give, so this is, so there are few, when you write a specification for memory, digital specification, there are analog specifications also. The digital specification is the number of address lines, then the control. This is the read, write and enable. These are the control lines and the data output, 8 bits. So this is the typical specification of 2 to the power k n read-write memory. This is a RAM. So if you write in VHDL or Verilog, you have to synthesize this by using this as a block diagram. So this is HM6264. If you see, it has got this. look at this, it has got, if you look at this, it has got A0 to A12. A0, A1, A2, A3 up to A12. Look at the second page. Can you see this second page?
Yes, sir.
In the second page, you see the IC chip has got 13 address lines, A0 to A12. And the block diagram is also specified below in the page 2 of HM6264. In the block diagram, you will find the row decoder, input data control, column IO, many things are there. We'll get back to this again, don't worry. Okay. So the RAM, basically, I said it has got, so this is SRAM, static RAM. We'll also talk about DRAMs. Okay. So generally static RAMs are much faster, but it consumes lots of power because 1 bit of static RAM will need several transistors. So then 1 bit of DRAM will need just one transistor, a capacitor, that's all. If you look at the screen, there is a static RAM, there is a dynamic RAM. So 1 bit of static RAM will need a flip flop. It's basically a flip and master slave arrangement. So it's a flip flop. So 1 bit of dynamic RAM is a capacitor. So we'll talk about DRAMs a little later. All your computing systems, laptops, whatever you do, and sometimes cell phones, not all cell phones, are basically DRAM with high refreshing rates. So DRAM is a capacitor. So the moment you write the data into the DRAM, what happens? This capacitor leaks out. So because of this leaking phenomena, you have to refresh it again and again because capacitor will discharge. Even if the capacitor doesn't have a path, but there is always a resistance, high resistance path to it. So the moment you refresh it, so you basically switch the capacitor, you connect by a transistor. This is a transistor. This capacitor you recharge, you charge it. The moment you charge, you open it. So this is supposed to remain like that. But what happens because of high resistance, which is leakage happens. So this becomes, this voltage comes down. So you have to intermittently refresh it. So therefore, DRAM circuit is a little complicated. There has to be, in addition to the standard layout of the array, memory array, there has to be a refreshing circuit, which will periodically refresh the DRAM. But DRAM consumes substantially lower space and lower power. But it is actually slow. Because once you want to read the DRAM, it has to be refreshing itself, then you read. Writing also same thing. So it is little slower than SRAM. So you can see SRAM 1 bit, 6 registers, but that is just master only slave. There could be a master slave arrangement also. So how do you make a capacitor? You can say.
Sir, we can use a MOS.
Mainak, Kanipaka, Kanipaka Sai Kalyan. Mainak, Kanipaka, how do you make a capacitor? Yeah, Kanipaka.
Yes, sir, we'll.
Kaise capacitor banaoge? How?
We'll take the plates and we'll keep it
plates in distance. IC chip to ek pura chala jayega capacitor banane mein. So what to do? How to make capacitors on IC chips? Krishna Pasala. Oi Krishna Pasala.
Sir, we can MOS capacitance using metal film.
Amruta Pedapati? Amruta?
Yes, sir.
Amruta?
Yes, sir.
How to make a capacitor?
By joining
breakfast.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So how do you make the capacitor?
By joining two plates.
On an IC chip? Because you have to make the memory synthesize on a chip. So how do you make a capacitor? Shreya.
Hello.
Yes, sir.
How do you make a capacitor?
I don't know about the IC chip.
Suppose I give you a MOSFET, can you use that like a capacitor? Siddharth Urwal.
Yes, sir.
If I give a MOSFET, can you make a capacitor? The headphone is going to be reflection.
So what?
If you don't use headphone, then there is a chance of reflection. Whatever I'm saying, it will feed back. You're using headphone.
Yes, sir.
But why there is reflection? Then there is headphone mein reflection nahi deta. So how do you make a capacitor, Siddharth? Suppose I give a MOSFET, can you make a capacitor? MOSFET padha hai na?
Yes, sir, but MOSFET
gate then drain or source. Gate and source do. Gate is having some insulator. So yes, between sir. The gate and source or drain, there is a capacitance. So the capacitors are also made out of MOSFETs. Remember this. So in an IC chip, you have a transistor using MOS, also capacitor using MOS. Okay. Yogesh Jadhav.
Yes, sir.
कैसे करेंगे एक रजिस्टर सपोज आई टू क्रिएट अ रेजिस्टेंस इन द आईस चिप इन वी हैव टू सिंथेसाइज अ सर्किट ना रेजिस्टेंस इज आल्सो रिक्वायर्ड सो हाउ टू मेक अ रेजिस्टेंस हाउ टू सिंथेसाइज अ रेजिस्टेंस इन द आईस चिप बहुत ही अच्छा अच्छा चीज में पढ़ा रहा हूं आप लोग थोड़ा अटेंशन देने से बहुत सुख सीख जाओगे I don't give bad grades. I am known for good grades. So attend the class. I am known for good grades, excellent recommendations, excellent projects. So be attentive. ठीक है अब 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 अभिजय मित्र
हाँ सर
कैसे करेंगे रेजिस्टेंस
सर डिफ्यूज रजिस्टर और एपिटेक्सियल रजिस्टर ऐसा कुछ होता है
यस थैंक यू यू हैव सम आइडिया सो यू कैन मेक इट यूजिंग सेम MOSFET बिकॉज़ बाय यू कैन बाय कनेक्टिंग द ड्रेन ड्रेन टू सोर्स लेंथ एंड द चैनल विड्थ यू कैन क्रिएट डिफरेंट रजिस्टेंस
यस
ओके सो यू कैन क्रिएट कैपेसिटेंस एंड रजिस्टर यूजिंग द MOSFET ओके गौरव गोवर्धन हाउ टू मेक अ Make an inductor. If you can answer this, I'll be very happy. Gaurav Govardhan, Bishan.
Yes, sir.
How to make an inductor?
Sir, I think here also we will use MOSFET. Here as well.
How?
Means we can make inductor from capacitor using that that negative resistance.
How to do that? How to do that? You are around that, but how to do it? Create an inductor, suppose.
Yeah, means we know that transformation technique of making a negative impedance, and we can use capacitor.
Inductor is not negative impedance. Inductor is not negative impedance. It is just a phase negative, but magnitude is not negative.
Mm.
So how to create inductor? All of you do this homework. Puja, give them homework number 2. You take an RLC circuit, okay? Got it?
Okay.
Take RC circuit. RL circuit. Suppose take an RL circuit. So it is basically a matter of delay. Capacitor will advance, the inductor will delay. So there is a concept of switched capacitor circuits. All of you,
excuse me, sir.
Yes. Who is speaking, please? Name, please.
Yukta. Sir, Yukta. Sir, you said that we can use MOSFETs as a resistor, but wouldn't that limit our voltage of operation in general? I mean, it is not linear in entire characteristics.
See, the linearity, MOSFET is not linear, that is true, but if you make a channel length adjust and you just fix the operating voltage, in that region, it will be behaving like a linear element. But if you create the full operating range, then of course it will not be linear. So it is around an operating point, it can be assumed to be linear. So in an IC chip, when you want to really synthesize a circuit, it is called circuit synthesis. Suppose you want to create a second order circuit, you have read Laplace transforms, all of you?
Yes, sir.
So if you take an RLC circuit, the impedance of the RLC circuit is a second order element, right?
Yes, sir.
So the second order element, if you want to synthesize using capacitors only, it is not possible. So there is something called switched capacitor circuits. So all of you please have a look what is known as switched capacitor circuit, because this is not in the purview of your course, but still you should understand. So therefore, the DRAM and SRAM synthesis you can do using MOSFETs only, okay? So because MOSFETs occupy very less area. What is the latest IC technology? Yukta, do you have any idea? How do you say it, IC technology? What is the qualifier? It is called micron, 5 micron. Now people are talking about nano. Okay, so very, very small micron. 5 micron means 5 × 10⁻⁹ -9 or -6, I don't know.
-6.
So you can see this micron technology, which gives you the space for the IC chips. The more less is the space, the less will be the voltage withstand capacity. So logic levels has to be substantially reduced. All right. Otherwise, if you give logic levels like ±12 volt, it will destroy the IC chip. So this is the DRAM and SRAM. So going further, you please download this HM6264, because I'm going to talk about it a little bit.
Sir, for making a inductance in the IC chip, can't we use a gyrator circuit so that we can put capacitance at one end and we'll get, and it will appear as inductance?
It is possible, but that will, again, you have an analog circuit there that will involve an op amp, all these stuffs. It will become again lots of transistors. So better have a switched capacitor circuit that will still reduce. Gyrator circuit can give you at one point like a negative, not negative inductance, but the minor J will come up. That is possible. But this will take again more space. So okay. You want to synthesize, not inductor exactly. You want to synthesize a circuit. Let's say second order impedance, S square plus some KS, K1S plus K2. You want to synthesize this. So this synthesis is basically differential equations. So this differential equation on the average should look like differential equations. So if you switch it very high frequency, you will find the average will turn out to be a capacitor switched at a particular delay. There will be two clocks. One capacitor will be switched at one phase, another will be a phase reversal. If you switch alternatively, it is possible to synthesize any circuit, which may involve otherwise an inductor. Otherwise, nowadays there are inductors which are called the embedded antennas. You know, you see in your cell phone, there is no antenna which is coming out. Earlier cell phone had an antenna coming out, but nowadays the antenna is actually, it is all SMD. It is surface mount. They will find lot of, you know, coils embedded onto the ice on the PCB. So that's also an inductor. But we are not talking about that. So please, we want to synthesize a particular circuit. So this could be done by switch capacitor circuits. Some instrumentation students will have this course actually. You have not read now, but you will have this course, switch capacitor analog circuits. Gyrator circuit also you can use, but that will involve lots of transistors again. So HM6264, please download, guys. HM6264. Okay, so going further, so memory chips, the most important specification of a memory chip, you'll find Nobody cares about the address, etc. Sorry, how many addresses? It is the read, write, bandwidth, and the power. These are the most important specifications of the MMG. The read, write time, the read bandwidth, and write, write. How fast you can read, how fast you can write, and how much power you will consume. These are the most important aspects of the memory. Time. Access time. This is called access time. Read access, write access, address setup, like that. Then power. So power consumption for an SRAM is very high, SRAM. And DRAM is much less, because the number of transistors are much less. So in this SM6264, power is about few microwatts. So 0.1 milliwatts, 100 microwatts, 10 microwatts, like that. Okay, and the power consumption per megahertz is about 15 milliwatt per megahertz. The access time is about 100 to 120 nanoseconds. You can see in the page 1, different varieties will have different access times. Minimum is 100 nanoseconds. So it will just, you give the address, it gives you the data. Equal access and cycle time, that means it is same read and write operation, same thing. And it has different packages. You know, there are different kinds of IC packages. Okay. So homework is, I am giving you a document. You please, all of you please have a look at this document about IC packaging. Look at this document from Fujitsu. All of you, please look at this document. You can note down, download this document, all of you. So here you get a lot of ideas about IC packaging. So the memory chips have different packages. So you can find here what is what kind of package is what, you can see here. So these are different packagings. Quad flat package, QFE, ball grid array, BGA, FPGA. Ball grid means whole IC chip on the bottom, there will be all similar array of pins coming out. So how the pins come out of the IC chip, how things are connected is very important, because that creates lots of parasitic capacitances, inductance, etc. So when you, I see when there is a conductor of finite length, the moment there is a high frequency current flowing into it, it will emit lot of electromagnetic waves, because if current, when it is flowing at high frequency, it will tend to make electric fields everywhere, magnetic fields everywhere. So that's why whenever the dimension of, and this will be proportional to the area of the physical conductor. The more is the area, the more will be the magnetic field and electric field. So therefore, the size of the pins should be very limited. The kind of SOP, for example, which you are seeing here, you know, thin shrink, small outline package, small outline lead package, then dual inline package, DIP. In this document is very important for you. Okay. So for example, the ball grid array, The DIP, dual inline packages, are very big conductors. So the frequency of operation is limited there. You got my point? Vaibhav Vishal? Hey, Vaibhav.
Yes.
Why there will be, if the conductor size is more, what is the problem? कंडक्टर साइज ज्यादा होने से आईसी चिप का क्या प्रॉब्लम है? आईसी पिन का
सर मोर हीट
है। यू आर नॉट पेइंग अटेंशन। क्या मूवी देख रहे हो सुबह सुबह? फिर क्या कर रहे हो? वैभव विशाल को एक क्रॉस मार्क डालो पूजा। If you're attending the class, be attentive, otherwise don't attend. I said I don't care about attendance. I told you. Devapriya.
Yes, sir.
So if the ICE, the DIP, Dwan Inline package, the conductor size is more than, what is the problem?
Yes, sir, cost.
Hey, isko bhi cross line maro. Ye bhi ye nahi tha. Deep, Harshit Kumar Barnwal.
Yes, sir.
देखो तुम्हारा ग्रेड पे मैं कुछ नहीं करूंगा, लेकिन अगर तुमको 79 होगा तुमको कभी ए नहीं दूंगा, समझे ना? ये असाइनमेंट में कट दूंगा मैं, समझे ना? इफ यू आर नॉट अटेंटिव, यू आर नॉट फाउंड अटेंटिव मोर देन टू टाइम्स, आई विल नॉट हेल्प यू। आई विल नॉट रिड्यूस योर ग्रेड, बट आई विल नॉट इंक्रीज योर ग्रेड। दैट इज व्हाट आई, दैट इज नो पनिशमेंट बट नो रिवार्ड ऑल्सो। So be careful. Harshit Kumar Barnwal.
Yes, sir. Hello.
If the conductor size is thoda jyada hai, DIP, Dwan Inline package mein conductor size is thoda bada hai. Jaise tumhara Arduino Nano board mein the microcontroller size is the, this is called dual inline packaging. The size of the conductors coming out of the IC chip is larger. What is the problem?
Sir, I think there will be more electric and magnetic interferences.
Why? Babakula Kirti Parsid, she will answer, I'm sure. Yes, she will answer.
Due to current flowing at high frequency.
And then what will happen? If the current flows in high frequency, so what? If the conductor is higher, then what will happen?
More magnetic and electric field.
Why? UFP stand, VGA stand for what? VGA, I said VGA chipping, VGA market. Ball grid array, okay. So anyway, so you are not, you guys are not attentive. What to do? I cannot do anything. Maulindu Sarkar, if the conductor size is high,
yes,
there will be high frequency interference.
Yes, sir.
So how can you prove it? Suppose there is a conductor carrying current I, what is the magnetic field nearby?
So B into I. In.
No, a conductor I, current. So this is the magnetic field at a distance R in free space.
Proportional to I.
Then एम्पियर्स लॉ यूज करके क्या कितना मिलता है आर डिस्टेंस में कंडक्टर, सपोज छोटा सिलिंड्रिकल कंडक्टर कैरिंग रेडियस वेरी स्मॉल कैरिंग करंट आई, व्हाट इज द
म्यू आई, म्यू आई बाय 2 पाई आर।
ओके, म्यू आई बाय 2 पाई, म्यू 0 आई बाय 2 पाई आर।
यस
सर। सपोज दिस कंडक्टर बिकम्स ए फ्लैट सरफेस।
यस सर।
ओके, व्हाट विल बी द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड? Suppose the current density is J. The conductor is a flat surface at a distance R from the surface, near the surface. What will be the magnetic field? Saugan.
Sir, yes, sir. Sir, so if we are considering a flat surface, then it, the magnetic field won't be dependent on the distance anymore. It will be an infinite plane, so it will be mu naught z by 2.
So That means if your surface becomes larger and larger, the magnetic field will change. Okay, now the question number two. It is to, let's say, Naman Panda. Okay. Can you tell me, Naman, what is, if the current changes in that flat surface very fast, what will happen to the magnetic field?
Yes, sir.
Naman Panda, not here. Naman Pahari, sorry.
Yes, sir.
So current changes means the magnetic field B will also change, right or wrong?
Yes, sir, it will change.
Okay, if B is changing, why not goes? If B is changing,
yes,
then around B, will there be any electric field?
No, sir. If B is changing, then there will be a field, but it is not necessary that the B will change. Because B is DI by D.
No, I change, so B is changing. So if B is changing, just around B at a distance, around B, will there be any electric field? Arsa leke mainak hota hai, electrical mein. Okay, bata. Whether there will be electric field around it or not. Jhansi Somya. Somya or Somya? Jhansi.
Yes, sir.
If the, at a particular point, the B is changing, magnetic field B is changing, just around that, will there be any electric field?
Yes, sir.
Suppose at a particular point, the magnetic field is changing. So in other words, let me put it this way. If I put a conductor around it, will there be any current?
Yes, the change in magnetic field can produce EMF.
EMF means electric field.
Electric field.
Yes. So if there is an electric field around it and there is no conductor and electric field is changing, will there be current?
Change in electric field also produces magnetic field around it.
No, I'm saying if there is an electric field around a cup, yes, you may be right, but you have to come to that conclusion. If there is a magnetic field changing, you said there will be an electric field around it. Okay. Suppose, yes, there is no conductor. Will there be current or not? That's my question.
No, sir. No current without a conductor.
Bah. Think. Ishan Bhutani?
Yes, sir.
If there is no conductor, will the current flow when there is a change in electric field?
Sir, without a conductor, there is no current, sir.
How can you say that? Hardik Man, let me ask our campus guy.
Yes,
if there is no conductor, okay, but there is changing electric field, whether current will flow or not? Okay. Harshit Barnwal, who can answer? Raise your hands.
Sir, eddy current can flow.
Now there are people who are very serious about it. Okay, Abrar Hussain to answer dega, mujhe pata hai. Abrar, batao.
Yes, sir, it can, current can flow. In
what
capacitor,
is
capacitor,
yes,
we see
it's
that there is
gap. Ko star EX dunga main. Okay, thank you very much. It's a displacement current which will flow, right?
Yes, sir, it's a displacement.
Compiler was not serious, I having some problems. So the current will still flow. That means if there is electric field, there will be a current, change in electric field. This current will create again magnetic field or not? Yashwant.
It will create. Yashwant.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
So this effect will propagate. That means if there is a conductor with adequate size, because the size matters, as you said. If it is just a thin conductor, the electric field at a distance will become point. You know, dipole will become small. A current dipole is a small area, right? And a thin conductor. So at last distance, the magnetic field will be Arif Javed proportional to what? Reversely proportional to R आर स्क्वायर आर क्यू क्या है आरिफ
सर कैन यू रिपीट आई वाज सर्चिंग फॉर द पीडीएफ
द पीडीएफ पीडीएफ छोड़ो ना अभी मुझे मेरा क्वेश्चन का आंसर दो सपोज आई हैव अ वेरी स्मॉल करंट लूप हैविंग वेरी थिन करंट थिन कंडक्टर एंड ए स्मॉल एरिया so at a large distance the magnetic field will due to this current will be proportional to 1 by r 1 by r square or 1 by r cube
sir 1 by r square
r cube nahi mujhe to lag raha hai 1 by r cube kya sai rohit theek hai so therefore the smaller is the loop the less is the effect of the magnetic field baad mein dekh lo tum ho sakta hai r square bhi ho sakta hai mera ko yaad nahi so my point is that if you make small ic pins the effect of the magnetic field at a distance will be reduced because if you have a large loop or large surface area the magnetic field will be more and if you change the current fast because it's a digital circuit current pulses are flowing every switching there will be inrush of current spike currents will flow digital circuits so this spike currents means extremely high frequency current so this will create interference because this will create changing magnetic field it will take changing electric field and changing current changing magnetic field so this is called electromagnetic wave which will propagate and if any other metal anywhere it is there it will be captured in that metal and it will start creating interference there Is it clear to you, Chauhan Prakash? Chauhan sir, क्या है ये इसको नाम क्या बोलते हैं उसको ये जो प्रोपागेशन को क्या बोलते हैं कौन सा प्रोपागेशन क्या हो रहा है The current producing magnetic field, producing electric field, current again back to magnetic field, again current like that it will propagate. What is this called? You are not at all attentive. I am very sorry about you, Chauhan. Class में क्यों हो भाई तुम? Chauhan, am I audible to you? Chauhan Prakash.
Sir, it's electromagnetic.
Yeah, you are trying to ask someone. देखो, Chauhan, ऐसे करने से कोई फायदा नहीं होगा तुम्हारा. IIT में पढ़ रहे हो, अपने आप को हीरो बनाओगे या जीरो? जीरो बन के इधर आ गए जीरो बन के निकलोगे ठीक है टेक केयर ऑफ योर ब्रेन टेक केयर ऑफ योर आईक्यू बिकम लिटिल सिंसियर इन द क्लास एनीवे सो लेट्स लुक एट दिस माय स्क्रीन इफ यू सी यू नो लेट मी एक्चुअली ये देखो ये सब क्या क्या पैकेज क्या है ये पूरा दिखाया गया इसमें क्यूएफई क्वाड फ्लैट पैकेज एलक्यूएफई लो प्रोफाइल क्वाड फ्लैट पैकेज थर्मली एनहांस पैकेज एचक्यूएफई स्मॉल आउटलाइन पैकेज सो इफ देयर आर टू मेनी पिन स्विच हैज टू कम आउट यू कैन नॉट जस्ट कम आउट फ्रॉम द साइड्स सो यू हैव टू मेक ए ग्रिड सो मोस्ट ऑफ योर प्रोसेसर्स व्हिच आर वेरी हाई हाई नंबर ऑफ पिन स्विच हैज टू कम आउट सो दे आर grid arrays everywhere there is you know connection to the chip so the dimension of the connection also matters a lot because a simple dimension small dimensions also creates inductance and capacitance okay all right so let's get back to your circuit so remember this memory synthesis is a big game of handling the electromagnetic interference and handling the clock without proper clock circuit clocks are high frequency signals so you have to be very careful about to manage the clock so coming back to the RAM so you guys can see my screen now memory screen again acha one more thing while coding in my class I have seen people are not looking at the Atmega you have to learn it yourself then only I will help you that microcontroller you have to read that manual otherwise you cannot write codes majid's book is very nicely explained everything if you
have any specific queries, you raise that query in the lab class. We will teach the magic, the book. You know, I have today morning, I see very nicely everything is given there. You know, you can directly copy paste programs also. That's the kind of book I saw. The AVR microcontroller and embedded system, assembly language coding, it is there, everything. Because I work on ARM related things, so I didn't see this book, but this is a good one. Branch call instruction is there, IO port programming, you see. Please see that book, you can learn very quickly. All right, so let's go back to memory. So there are lot of variations of this simple RAM, like pseudo-static RAM, where there is SRAM and DRAM together. Then there is non-volatile RAM, when the static RAM is having a backup. So let's look at these two chips, which I just now shared. It is HM6264, which you are talking, which is a RAM chip, and there is a ROM chip, 27256. So if you look at the 27256 and HM6264, the specification, basically the time. One is this 13-bit memory, and this 27256 is 256 kilobits, I think. Yeah. There are 16 address lines, as you can see here. It's 27256, but it is a wrong. Here the mark, there are only 13 address lines. HM6264.
Sorry, it's not visible.
Not visible. I'm sorry about it. I'll just do it again. Visible to hai, kyun nahi? Chalo, main isko change kar deta. अब दिख रहा है तो
यस सर
सो आई जस्ट टोल्ड दैट देयर आर डिफरेंट वेरिएशंस ऑफ रैम दिस व्हाट आई हैव शोन देन यू कैन सी टू ऑफ द चिप्स देयर इज अ मिस्टेक टाइपो हियर इन HM6264 इट इज एक्चुअली 13 बिट्स नॉट 16 बिट्स दैट इज अ टाइपो डोंट वरी अबाउट इट यू गो टू द एक्चुअल डाटा शीट 27256 एंड HM6264 डाटा शीट व्हिच इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू. So let's focus on this. It's 27256. Just as a concept. So if you look at the access time, it is faster than the RAM generally. Okay, and the standby power consumption here is little higher than active power. Whenever it is operating for the RAM or EEPROM, it is higher. Voltage is same, 5 volt each. So if you look at the speed, etc., actually the standby power consumption is plus flash memory is much less. This 27256 is little higher. So this is called timing diagram. This is just as a concept we are reading. This is called this diagram which you see here. They are known as timing. These are extremely required for designing digital circuits. For example, how to access, make a read operation. For example, this one says about the read operation. So you have to send the address first because you want to read from a location. So address takes some time. That is called address setup time, because address is loaded from the to address buffer. Then it goes to the memory. There is a buffer there also. So there is an address setup time after which you send the output enable, means read output. Then chip select. Chip select is to select the particular chip. That can be a part of addressing also. Then you make output enable, and then data comes in. So by the time you send the address and get the data, so data, this data comes in the data lines, which which are connected to the processor. So then the data is sampled, or it goes to the data buffer or any register. So this whole phenomena from here to here, that is called the read time. This is called read time. Then one operation of the read time is called known as read bandwidth. Okay. Similarly, for write operation, you have to send the data and address together, and after some time, you can also send the chip select, CS1, CS2, or chip select. CS1 bare means it will be active low. So then you have got the write enabled. Then the total time, how much time you have to hold the data, is known as write access time. So this is read access and write access. Let's go to the particular chip 27256, HM6264. You have to do. Okay, we'll. Okay, so today's assignment to you at 9:30, I will give you 9:25, which you have to solve and upload in 30 minutes. It will be best done interfacing of this one of the chips. I will tell you what. Okay. So this 27256 chip layout, as you can see, it is a DIP package, not a boot package. So if you make it, you know, high bandwidth, it will not work because it will radiate, it will interfere at least. So you got, you see, A0 to A14, 15 address lines. Can you see? Starting from 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, then 27, 26, 25, 24, 23, 22, 21. So there are 14 address lines here, right? So in these 14 address lines, in the 14 address lines, you can go up to 2 to the power 14 locations. So that is how much, and 8-bit each. So 16 kilobytes, which is 16 into 8, which is 256 bits. So that's why the name is 256. So these are outputs, O0, O1, O2, O3, O4, O5, O6, O7. Then there is a chip enable line, there is an output enable line, sorry. So there is an output enable line. You can see output enable is for read. Then there is a chip enable line. Then it has two modes. One is called read mode, and one is called write. Yes.
Sir, can you repeat this, sir? Here, sir, 15 address lines are there, sir. Why did you write 14 address lines?
15 address lines, okay. So it is 15 address lines, 2 to the power 15, I said. 2 to the power 15, number of things. So 2 to the power 15 is how much? 2 to the power 5, 32 kilobytes. 32 kilobytes means 32 into 8, that is 256 bits. Thank you for the mistake, pointing out the mistake. Jo jisne bola usko thoda acha star de do, puja. Star wale ko to main grade badhaunga agar borderline mein honge to. Theek hai. Abrar Hussain ko to ek grade milega acha, lekin acha nahi karne se nahi milega. Theek hai, lekin जो दिस नॉट एट हु इज नॉट नॉट अटेंटिव, अच्छा करने से भी बुरा हो सकता है, कोई संभाल नहीं सकता, कोर्ट में जाना पड़ेगा ग्रेड बढ़ाने के लिए. ठीक है. सो इट हैज गॉट टू मोड्स. वन इज कॉल्ड रीड मोड,
is a standard mode. Another is known as programming mode. Programming means you have to burn it. In the programming mode, this VPP, the programming voltage will be little higher. So this has to be done by special programmers. Like you have got these in-circuit emulators. In-circuit emulators. ICE, remember. It is called in-circuit emulators for program embedded systems. In-circuit emulators. These are nothing but programmers. It will have a JTAG interface. So it will be connected to your desktop where you write your code and then dump it. Like your Arduino Nano board which you are doing, it is an in-circuit emulator. All right. So you can use this Arduino Nano board for developing your products. Okay, so this has got certain, so you got it, no? So it's a very simple chip. When you use it, it will be in the read mode. It will be done by addressing, then making the chip select, then one chip enable line. Then if once you connect it, then you got. So this chip enable line is required because you want to synthesize more memory. Suppose you have got 16 address lines. You have got A0 to F15, which is 16 address lines. And one of the address lines can be connected to chip enable. So whenever it is low, it will select one chip. So that means the 15th address lines can have two things. One is connected to a inverter like this. So it will go to one chip, chip number one. This will go to another chip, memory chip. So together using chip two. So together with other 14 lines, I can address two chips. So that means I can synthesize 64 kilobytes by two chips using 16 address lines. So that is how it's called memory synthesis. We'll come back to that. So this is how, you know, the basic MOSFET structure. There is a gate, there is a floating gate. So you can fuse them to make it on, or you can just open them. So this connection and disconnection can be made by use of ultraviolet rays or higher. Then you can do higher voltage to this programming voltage is maybe it is higher. So this can be connected or disconnected. So that is the principle of programming this EEPROM. Don't worry about that. So this is the connection. You know, this is either they are connected or not connected. These are bit lines, these are rows. Once you select a particular row, then the number, depending upon the connection, no connection, the output will be either high or low. All right. So going further, the address inputs, chip enable, output enable, programming voltage, so these are all the pins which I've got. These are the access time, which you discussed about it. This read access time, not write access. This is the current which is required. This is high current, not so good. This is standard. This is nanoampere, not my milliampere. This is nanoampere. So this is also, this is microampere. Micro, not milliampere. Milliampere is too high. 20 microampere, and this is 100 nanoampere. That's what is requirement. Milli is a mistake. You can see that later. So this is the specification. This is called electrical specifications, remember. So what are the specifications? Timing specification, and there is an electrical specifications. Okay, so this says that input voltage, you can range between them, minus 0.60. If it is beyond that, chip might be damaged. This is the programming voltage, which is up to 14 volts. Voltage at A9 cannot be beyond that. That means with respect to VSS, it will puncture the chip, and storage temperature. So everything is specified here. So from the manufacturer side, let's look at the read waveforms. Yeah. So this is called read timing. So read timing is, so as I said, this is called high logic level, this is low logic level, sorry.
This is the higher logic level VIH, lower logic level. So in the TTL logic, the high logic level is specified in this range. This is the diagram for TTL. If this is 5 volts, this is 0, there are certain bands. These bands are represented by VIH, VIL, this is VIH, this is VIL. That means the maximum voltage which will be recognized as 0. Then VIH is minimum voltage which will be recognized at 1, like that. Then there is VOH. So your homework is to know about this VOH, VOL. Try to find out this for the AGTL logic, AGTL logic. This is homework 3. Please create the homework 3. Find out the specs of AGTL logic. Puja, please create this homework. Homework 1 was given, homework 2 was given, homework 3. Homework 1 is find out the flash chips, flash memory chips. Homework 2 has what, Puja? I forgot.
Sir, they have to take RLC circuit and
yeah.
concept about the switch capacitor.
So these 3 homeworks let them do. Okay. These homeworks they have to upload. Homework doesn't have exclusive marks, but lot of impressions. Homework has grades, but not marks. So similar. So this is VIL. This is VIH. This is VIL. So first you put the address. At that time you set up the address. So the address lines will be connected to the memory. So address is valid. Then after some time the chip enable has to be made low. This sometimes comes with the address, as I said. Then after some time you make the output enable low. So after some time, so these outputs initially will be in the high impedance state. That means nothing. The bus will be connected to inside of the EEPROM. Then after address access, this is called access time. This is known as address setup time. You will see that. So here the output will come. So the output will remain valid. Then after some time, so these are the different specifications, timing specifications, which will be supplied by your manufacturer. This is reading. Similarly, there is also programming waveforms. Why do you write program? How you will write the data into it? So in the programming, so this is reading, this is programming. Okay, so in the programming, you have to set up the address first. So it has got 2 steps. After you write, then verify. There is a writing and there is a verification. Both are there. So you write, program means write. So what you do is you first give the address and make the voltage VPP higher. VPP will be 13 volts, as you can see here. From 5 volts, you rise it to 13 volts. Then VCC will be 6.5 volts. Then chip enable has to be low. This is where you make the data, then you make the chip enable low. So what will happen? This address will automatically gets, it will go to the, in this address, the data will be written. Then after some time, make the output enable low to read the data and verify. This data and that data should be same. The processor will verify. And then the programming of one location is over. So the timings, these are the different timings, TIS, TDS, TBPS, TBCS, TDH, all these things, you know, all these things will be specified in the data sheet. So let me,
excuse me,
please tell me.
Sir, while verification, why is the VPP 13 volts, like that is at 13 volts for programming only, right? Not really.
That is made high because you don't have to switch it back. So data will automatically get loaded, come back. So when you do the output low, the data will be coming back and you can verify by external circuit if the same data is there or not. Okay, so VPP during programming, you can keep the programming voltage. That is how the manufacturer made it. so that you can immediately do programming. You don't have to lower the voltage.
Wait for the switch. Okay.
Yes. So in the external circuit, you can verify whether it is right or wrong. Okay. So now some applications of EEPROM or EEPROM, whatever. Very good applications are there. So can anyone tell me wonderful applications of this EEPROM? Anshul Rajendra Tembare. Anshul sir, boliye.
Yes, sir.
So application boliye kya hai?
Application.
Forget about program. Forget about the embedded systems. It can be very nicely. It can be a very wonderful combinatorial circuit. Any logic, combinatorial logic, you can burn using EEPROM. Right or wrong?
Yes, sir.
Because if there are 16 input, 15 inputs to this circuit, and there are 8 outputs, so 15 to 8 synthesis of any combinatorial logic you can do or not?
Yes, sir.
You can do. Very good. Orko Prabha Madhu?
Yes, sir.
So can you tell me other applications? So this, I said that you can do any combinatorial logic using this EEPROM. Can I generate a waveform? Can I make an arbitrary waveform generator using this EEPROM?
Yes.
How?
Sir, because we are using the previous specification. So if we change a new to a new type of settings, then maybe we will be able to generate again a new kind of waveform.
What are you saying? You are, I'm not getting you. What you say, I have not got you at all. So for generating a waveform, you can connect a D2A converter to the output of EEPROM. So 8 bit is there, no? So yes. You connect the DA converter. So then how to generate the waveform? Hetar.
Yes, sir.
So suppose the EEPROM which you just saw, you connect to DA, D2A converter, 0808, which you have done in Proteus, at least. So then I want to generate an arbitrary waveform. So what to store in these locations? So this is the assignment for you today. Today's assignment is, you go to the internet, I am giving you 45 minutes approximately. Or 40 minutes. You go to internet. You find a counter. Okay. You take this EEPROM 27256. You make an arbitrary waveform generator. Make a full wave rectifier output. Okay. You make the complete design and submit this assignment by evening. So you are having a clock circuit. So let me tell you how to do it. All of you please listen. And everybody's design should be unique, okay? Look at this. I am not asking you any embedded system stuffs. I am just asking you take a clock circuit. Crystal oscillator circuit, crystal clock. Let's hello. उसमें क्रिस्टल लगाओ फिर वेवफॉर्म जनरेट करो ऐसे पॉइंटर ऐसे जाएगा देन यू हैव अ काउंटर क्रिएट टेक अ काउंटर सर्किट फ्रॉम द नेट 16 बिट काउंटर ले सकते हो जो भी ले सकते हो ये काउंटर जैसे रिसेट होगा ठीक है 16 बिट काउंटर ले जाओ 16 बिट काउंटर एक को यूज मत करो सो 15 बिट काउंटर हो गया नहीं तो 16 बिट काउंटर लो या 15 बिट काउंटर भी ले सकते हो जो भी है तुम्हारा इच्छा यू कनेक्ट दिस 27256 दो चिप लगाओ एक काउंटर का आउटपुट सब कहां जाएगा उनका एड्रेसिंग में जाएगा दोनों का तो इसका आउटपुट हो गया वो 02 ओ 8 ठीक है एक लो नहीं एक लेने से होगा तो उसको डीए कन्वर्टर लगाओ डीए डिजिटल टू एनालॉग कन्वर्टर तो आउटपुट में ऐसा आना चाहिए वेवफॉर्म। तो पहले इसको डिजिटाइज करके उसमें सेव करो। सो बोलो कि ये सब वर्ड सेव है, इफ आई पुट ए क्लॉक एंड काउंटर इट विल कीप ऑन जनरेटिंग दिस फॉर इनफाइनाइट टाइम। तो ये सर्किट बना के आज शाम तक 6 PM 8 PM रख दो, 8 PM डेडलाइन, ठीक है पूजा
सर।
हाँ
सर, 6 to 9 लैब होता है और कल टेस्ट है सर, काफी दिक्कत हो जाएगा।
इसे पहले कर दो, इसे पहले कर दो, ठीक है, इसे पहले भी कर सकते हो ना, अभी तो टाइम है, अभी तुम क्लास का अंदर करो, जो क्लास का अंदर अभी कर देगा तो आई विल बी गिविंग देम एक्स्ट्रा मार्क्स, बट आई एम टेलिंग दोज हु डोंट वांट टू डू नाउ, यू पुट डेडलाइन एट 6 PM, अभी करो उसको, अभी मैं तुमको क्लास का टाइम देता हूं।
सर वी हैव टू सिमुलेट इट?
नो सिमुलेशन, जस्ट डिजाइन, नेट से क्रिस्टल ऑसिलेटर सर्किट बनाओ, क्रिस्टल क्लॉक, क्रिस्टल ऑसिलेटर सर्किट, उसको इंटरनेट से डाउनलोड करो, फिलिप्स जो भी है, एक डिजिटल काउंटर लाओ, 16-bit काउंटर या जो भी है, वो काउंटर का आप क्या करो, उसका MSB जो है ना उसको मत यूज करो, मोस्ट सिग्निफिकेंट। अरे एक पार्डन,
हेलो सर,
हां
सर, आई हैव अ डाउट इन द प्रोग्रामिंग वेवफॉर्म, द स्लाइड, प्रोग्रामिंग वेवफॉर्म स्लाइड
ना, ठीक है, हां वो डाउट में बताता हूं, आई विल कम बैक टू दैट, फर्स्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, ओके। सो क्या प्रोग्रामिंग वेवफॉर्म का क्या प्रॉब्लम है? हां बोलो
सर, इन दैट स्लाइड कैन यू शो दैट?
आई एम शोइंग दैट स्लाइड, आई डोंट नॉट एबल टू सी दिस।
या So, sir, the TAS, TDS, TVPS, and TVCS, they all the 4 time period are the same. Means these time period between the same.
These are specific timings. There are some names like access time, you know, VPS table time, TVCS table time. All these are some names are there. This will be in the manufacturing specifications. That's what your homework will be for tomorrow. Tomorrow we'll see that, sir.
Sir, but in the figure they have shown in between the same 2 points, same 2 lines they have shown.
The ठीक है, वो थोड़ा इधर उधर है, but वो same है, almost same है, don't worry about that. थोड़ा सा इधर है, वो data stable का कहीं पे भी हो सकता है, उसमें थोड़ा सा uncertainty होगा, ठीक है? लेकिन same line दिखा है, लेकिन वो data stable का बीच में कहीं पे भी हो सकता है, ठीक है? Data stable, VPS stable, VCS stable. ये थोड़ा बहुत इधर उधर होगा, ये बीच में दिखा दिया लेकिन वो सेफ नहीं है, ठीक है, वो कल देखेंगे पूरा मैन्युफैक्चरिंग स्पेसिफिक्स, ठीक है अमन? हेलो,
यस सर, यस सर।
तो ये सर्किट बनाओ, ठीक है, एक ऑसिलेटर ले लो जो क्लॉक जनरेटर करेगा, जो एक काउंटर को ड्राइव करेगा, काउंटर का आउटपुट एड्रेस ड्राइव करेगा, एड्रेस ईच एड्रेस में क्या डिजिटल इक्विवेलेंट स्टोर करना है उसको, ये देखो ये फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर है ना, वो फुल वेव रेक्टिफायर जैसा वेफर होना चाहिए, तो उसको डिजिटाइज करना है, ठीक है? तो ये असाइनमेंट आप अभी करो, मेरे को तो आई एम आस्किंग यू टू सबमिट बाय 10 AM, बट दोज हु वांट टू टेक मोर टाइम आई विल नॉट कंसीडर इट रॉन्ग, ओके? सो यू बट टुडे बाय टुडे इवनिंग नाइट यू कैन डू सबमिट, ओके पूजा?
सर वी हैव टू सबमिट अ हैंडमेड सर्किट।
हैंडमेड भी कर सकते हो, हैंडमेड करने से अच्छा है, लेकिन वो आईसी नंबर फंबर कौन सा किस में जाएगा कनेक्शन, ये थोड़ा टेबल करना,
ओके
एक टेबल कर दो, कनेक्शन का टेबल कर दो, कनेक्शन दिखाने का जरूरत नहीं है, बोल दो कि ये आईसी नंबर है, यहाँ से ये कनेक्शन गया, एक कंसेप्ट रहना चाहिए बस और कुछ नहीं, दिस फॉर योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग, ठीक है? 2 पेज का अंदर खत्म करना है, you do not have more pages for this, you can type or do whatever you like, but don't copy, if you are copying then actually it will not be a good idea for you, you please start, those who submit by 10 AM I will be very happy, I am there, okay Pooja, create this assignment, so 3 homeworks and this assignment for today.
Yes sir, I will create.
Homeworks they can submit in this week anytime, no problem, but this assignment they have to submit today.
Sir, sir.